Hi, this is Simon with IQRF. This video is for those who want to have their wireless network up and running within few minutes and without any programming. We will use the development set DSDP01 for practical real-time demonstration how easy and fast is to create a wireless mesh network with IQRF data controlled transceivers. So, let's start. Open the IQRF startup package and go to the applications and the DPA file. The custom DPA handler is a topic of another video, so now we open the demo hardware profile and run the prepare demo IDE project. As you can see, we have a demo hardware profile for our coordinator and for our nodes ready here. If you want to modify configuration of your transceivers, you can double click on the TR configuration. The first window is to configure the operating system, so you can set up a band, channel, wireless programming and so on. The other window is then for hardware profile configuration. You can select here peripherals that you want to have available on your modules. Some of the peripherals use the same pins, so you cannot use SPI and UR peripherals simultaneously, for instance. In the RF part, you can select the transmitting power from 0 to 7 and a level of RX filter. Please note that the RX filter 35 is pretty high and it's pre-set up for your initial tests in a room. If you want to see the real range of the modules, you can set up the RX filter to the level 5, let's say. Now we have everything ready and we can upload the hardware profiles and the configuration into our modules. In the DSDP01, you will find 6 modules. We added tags with numbers so you can recognize which node we communicate with. Then there are 4 evaluation boards and 2 programmers. First of all, we will upload the node hardware profile. We plug the first module into the programmer and the programmer to our PC. Then we just tick that we want to upload the node hardware profile and that we want to add the TR configuration. Hitting F5 or this button, both of those files will get uploaded to the transceiver. This is what you will do with all the 5 modules and you will plug them into the evaluation boards. You should see the modules are flashing red for 10 seconds. This is a good sign that the hardware profile was successfully uploaded and that the modules are not bonded yet. You plug the node number 5 into the second programmer and connect it to your computer. You can have more USB devices connected to the IQRF IDE, and in the USB device manager here, you can set up which one you want to work with. Now we plug in the coordinator module and we upload the coordinator hardware profile and the same configuration. In order to double check that the coordinator hardware profile was successfully uploaded, you can refresh the map view in the IQ Mesh Network Manager and you will see your coordinator there without any nodes bonded. Now we need to add our nodes into the network of our coordinator. The process is called bonding, or maybe you know it as pairing. We make this window a little bit bigger so you can see how the nodes are added in the matrix down here. The process of bonding is very simple. You just hit the button Bond Node in your IDE and you have 10 seconds to push the application button on your evaluation board. Once you do it, the node gets bonded and an orange bullet pops up in the matrix. This is the process how you can bond all your nodes just within few seconds. If you want to unbond certain node, there are 2 basic ways how to do it. The first one is to send a command which will unbond the node on the node as well as on the coordinator side. You will see that the module starts flashing red instantly. Another way is to unbond the node only in the coordinator. In that case, the coordinator deletes the node from his network database, but the node is not aware of this. So, you have to unbond the node manually. You do it in the way that you hold the application button and you push the reset button on your evaluation board. You will see the green LED shining for about 2 seconds. You should release the button immediately when the green LED stops shining. You have about half second to do so. If you succeed, the red LED will start flashing. Please note that in the cases when you have your module bonded and you upload a new hardware profile or configuration, your modules will stay bonded to the original coordinator. So, before you start bonding, please make sure that your module is properly unbonded. So we've bonded our nodes again, and to communicate in a network we have to run discovery. This is an automated procedure which sets up the network topology. In order to show you a bit more complex topology than a star, I will put these 2 modules into the small bag and drop them with the other 2 modules on the other side of my table. I will also decrease the TX power of the discovery to a very low level. The TX power should be in general lower than the power used in your application. On the map view, you can check the topology of the network, and since all the nodes are blue, we know that the discovery was successful. Now you have the network fully ready for sending your commands or reading data from your nodes. This is the way how you can have your wireless network up and running within few minutes. The following video will show you how to communicate in this network and will explain you the DPA protocol. If you want to learn more, you can refer to these IQRF guides or browse on the IQRF.org. So, don't be afraid of making your products wireless. It's simple. This video is just a small piece of a complete IQRF video tutorial set. To get a full picture and understanding of the IQRF technology, please watch previous and following IQRF tutorials.